Hey everyone, I hope this video finds you well and making the most of your day. If you are new here, I'm Christopher and welcome, welcome, welcome. If you like lifestyle, luxury, skincare, product reviews, planning and organization, stop and look no further, my friend, because this place is for you. It seriously has something for everybody, and I am so excited that you decided to join us. If you like those things, go ahead and click that little red subscribe button and join the community. And if you're gonna hang out with us here on YouTube, you might as well hop on over to my Instagram. I'll leave my handle right here on the screen. I post over there daily. It is a great way to have touch points. Also, there's gonna be something special happening on Instagram based on this video, so you definitely wanna catch up with me over there. And I look forward to hanging out with you and getting to know you more. Today I'm bringing a much requested video, and that is a meal prep video. So many of you have been asking what I do to meal prep for the week. So that is what I'm giving you today. So without further ado, I'm just going to jump straight in. The first part of meal prep is logging and keeping track of meals. This way you can see what you made, when you made it, so that you're not repeating meals super frequently. I keep all of those in my bullet journal. Now you will see that this is a different bullet journal from my original bullet journal videos. That is because my bullet journal that had months and months of dinner logs met its demise when a full bottle of water spilled on it and soaked through literally every single page. So I had to start new. Now that is quite disappointing because all the meal logs that I have are just for the month of July. All that I simply do is I write the meal and the date. That way I can see like what are our favorites that we always go to, and I'll plug those in more frequently, and what were new recipes that I want to repeat, and just to make sure that our weeks are very varied and we don't always have the same meals over and over again, because it is easy to get into a food rut. So that is my first meal prep tip. Keep track of the meals, know which ones your family likes the most so that you don't constantly repeat them and you always have a running list to go to. Now it's time to plan your meals for the week. For Steven and I, we only plan for Monday through Friday because Saturday we'll sometimes go out or have leftovers, and Sunday we usually like keep it pretty flexible and simple. But during the work week, it is really important that we know what we're having each night of the week. So I sit down on the weekends and plan out our meals for Monday through Friday. Sometimes I dive into cookbooks and pull new recipes. Sometimes I have ones that I found online throughout the last week that I want to use. Or most of the time, I just reference all of my meal logs and see what I haven't made in a while and things that we liked that we kind of forgot about. But sadly, I don't have that meal log to go off of, so I'm gonna do a lot of memory work and think about things that I made that we really, really enjoyed that we maybe haven't had in a while or had recently and just loved so much. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and talk you through what I'm thinking for this week. One thing that Steven and I strive to do during the week is to have some meatless meals. So for Monday this week, I'm going to make some vegetarian enchiladas. For Tuesday, I think we're going to have chicken parm that is baked and super healthy. It's delicious. For Wednesday, we are going to revisit our Buddha bowls. I'm going to make a different version of them. We really, really enjoyed them. On Thursday, we're going to have some quinoa bowls with vegetables and a chili lime dressing that is delicious. And then on Friday, we are going to have tacos. Now that my meals are planned, I'm going to go ahead and make my ingredients list. Now, these are recipes that are not from cookbooks, so I just simply know what I want to do with them, and most of them are going to lean on the side of creativity and what I want to add. I'm also then going to cross-reference my pantry list and just cross off anything that I don't need to buy at the store because it's already here at the house. I'm also going to dive into the refrigerator and see what produce I need to use up, because that will shape what my Buddha bowls or my quinoa bowls look like this week, so I don't waste anything. I will put all of my ingredients in my Louis Vuitton desk agenda. I use the graphic image notebooks with them. This is kind of my brain dump for work. So there are meeting notes, there are my people boxes that I talk about a lot in my Plan With Me videos, and also my grocery list, home projects, things like that. I just create a new section for each week, kind of like you would for a bullet journal. And I list out my grocery list for the week. Then when I go to the grocery store, I tuck my debit card and my ID and my Shoppers Club card right here in the pocket of my desk agenda. And this is all I carry into the grocery store. I love the desk agenda. I find it to be one of the most versatile pieces in my planner collection. And I simply, simply love it. So I will go ahead and make my grocery list and then have a few more things for you. When I make my grocery list, I do not divide it by how the store is set up, like produce section, meat section, things like that. Instead, I really focus on making sure that I set it up by day of the week and the meal that I'm having. Now that I have our meals planned for the week, my grocery list done, I have cross-referenced the pantry and the refrigerator to make sure I don't buy anything I don't need and I do not waste anything that we already have. I transfer all of our meals over to this dry erase board that lives inside our pantry. If you didn't see my pantry organization vlog, I will put that in the description box below so you can check it out. But this lives in the pantry as a quick reference guide of what meal we're having each day of the week. And also Steven can check it out to see what we're eating. So now that that is done, this will go and hang back up in the pantry and I'm going to head off to the grocery store. When I come back from the grocery store, I will transfer all of our ingredients into meal prep baskets. I keep 5 of these for Monday through Friday. What goes inside of these baskets is any part of that meal for that day that doesn't need to be refrigerated. This saves you so much time. I did a whole video on my meal prep baskets. I'm gonna leave that linked in the description box below. So when Monday comes and it is time to make those vegetarian enchiladas, I will pull this off the shelf. It'll have every ingredient I need. I can grab the few things that I'll need from the refrigerator, throw this on the counter, and prep the meals so, so quickly. So that is my meal prep process. I hope that you found this video really, really helpful. I also hope that you see by tracking your meals in a couple different locations helps you stay really organized, speed up the process, and gives you a great variety to your meals throughout the weeks. If you liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and also leave any comments down below about any meal prep tips that you may have. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them. One thing you should know about my channel is I answer every single YouTube comment. Now, here is the catch. I wanted to make this super interactive and super fun. Starting on Monday, I am going to Instagram the story for each of these 5 recipes. I cannot wait to share that experience with you. We've done a couple meals over on Instagram stories and you seem to love it. So not only with this video are you getting the meal prep ideas, if you follow me over on Instagram, you will get 5 new recipes that are quick and so simple, and you will see this whole meal prep process in action. I can't wait to catch up with you over there, and I will leave this video like I leave all of them. Take care of yourself, take care of others, and be kind. Kindness is free, my friends. Give it to everyone. Until next time, bye-bye.